I would like to call this meeting to order. I'd like to welcome each of you to the November 2018 meeting of the City of Reading's Historical Architectural Review Board. Thank you for your attendance this evening. Chapter 295 of the City of Reading's Codified Ordinances requires that the HARB be guided by the United States Secretary of the Interior Standards for Rehabilitation and Guidelines for Rehabilitating Historic Buildings, Chapter 180 Construction Codes, and by any policies and/or guidelines hereafter adopted by the Board or the City of Reading. While meetings of the HARB are generally informal, Robert's Rules of Order are used to structure the proceedings and maintain decorum. We ask that all attendees please turn off cell phones and electronic devices until the meeting is adjourned. The audio portion of these proceedings will be recorded for record-keeping purposes. When an applicant hears the name of his or her property called by the chair, they should come to the front, sign in on the sign-in sheet, and wait for the preservation officer to present the summary of the application proposal. The chair will then recognize the applicant when the time is appropriate for him or her to present any supporting information to the board. Applicants are asked to limit their presentation to 3 minutes. So we received the September 2018 minutes this afternoon. Has the board had the opportunity to review those?
No, just
no?
Now.
Okay.
I'm looking through them for the first time.
So it's 401 Douglas was in those minutes. Should I abstain from approving the minutes?
That's true. I guess you should.
Okay.
So that leaves only two voting members. I don't want to hold things up.
Okay.
And I hate to
just rush through that.
That's
okay.
A chance to read.
Okay, that's fine. All right, so is there a motion to postpone the approval of the September 18th? Okay, is there a second? Okay,
so.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, opposed? Okay, you'll have the next month to review those, and we'll review those at the next meeting then. Okay.
They're done.
They're done, right. Yep, they are finished, which is good. Yep. Okay, are there any conflicts of interest on tonight's agenda?
Three and four,
okay. Okay, so
Erin has.
I'm sorry.
Number six, the staff approvals, because you're on there.
Oh, I didn't even realize that. Yes, I do have.
So you will.
Sorry, not speak for you, but.
Thank you. No. I didn't pick up on that.
Okay. All right. So we would like to have the applicant for 1818 Lorraine Road please come forward. Sir, if you would sign in, please.
Okay.
And then Ms. Johnson will read the property summary.
The subject property is a one-story mid-century modern structure located within the Heights Conservation District with a single-story garage located at the northern facade. The structure features a coarse stone on a portion of the facade and windows with vertical mullions. The structure received a site quality survey rating of 82 and is a significant contributing building in the district. And the Secretary of the Interior's standards that apply are number two, the historic character of a property shall be retained and preserved. The removal of historic materials or alteration of features and spaces that characterize a property shall be avoided. Number five, distinctive features, finishes, and construction techniques or examples of craftsmanship that characterize a historic property shall be preserved. Number six, deteriorated historic features shall be repaired rather than replaced. Where the severity of deterioration requires replacement of a distinctive feature, the new feature shall match the old in design, color, texture, and other visual qualities, and where possible, materials. Replacement of missing features shall be substantiated by documentary, physical, or pictorial evidence. Number nine, new additions, exterior alterations, or related new construction shall not destroy historic materials that characterize the property. The new work shall be differentiated from the old and shall be compatible with the massing, size, scale, and architectural features to protect the historic integrity of the property and its environment. And finally, number 10, new additions and adjacent or related new construction shall be undertaken in such a manner that if removed in the future, the essential form and integrity of the historic property and its environment would be unimpaired. And tonight we are reviewing the proposal for the enclosure of an existing carport at the northern end of the structure, of which is currently underway. And we have the owner, if you want to just explain a little bit about your project.
Well, what we're doing is closing in the carport so we can use it as a garage and slash wood shop and storage.
Okay.
And there's a stone, the exterior wall of the house is stone, and Jim Moore was over yesterday to look at it, and he said that's not going to be a problem. And the only thing he said that would have to be done that we weren't doing is put a half-inch drywall above this on the ceiling of the house. It goes into, it's a rancher, so there's not a living space up above it, but just to...
So you would be...
Be with code.
Okay, yeah. Okay. Is that for a fire?
Yes,
okay,
for okay, fire rating, right, okay. Because the car, or the, sorry, the garage is attached to a living space.
Exactly, yeah. Okay. Yeah. Okay. And then how far have you gotten on the project then?
There's one wall up.
Okay.
And three windows.
Okay, all there. Right, okay. So it's framed in, it's wrapped?
Yeah, okay. It's wrapped on
okay.
It, yes.
Okay, very good. All right. Does the board have some questions about work at this point?
One of the questions that the board had question on was the garage door. The picture that you submitted had windows that were going to be like a sunrise type effect, but you were told they were not going to be. They were going to just be plain glass?
Yes.
Is that correct?
Yeah. Yeah, I had submitted pictures.
Yes, mm-hmm. Yeah, the board has those. Thank you.
Yeah. Yes, they've all been
set.
Yeah, we have a picture
your
of the garage
plans.
Door that had the sunburst, not the plain
right.
Glass.
Right.
Make sure we're clear on that.
Mm-hmm. I believe another point that the executive committee had brought up was the style of the windows that's used in the garage as they relate to the style of the windows in the house. The configuration is different. And is that a concern for the board?
Was there a reason why double hung was used in lieu of sliders?
My wife just liked that style better. That's what she had chose. No other particular reason.
And this is actually the style of the house. It is mid-century modern, but it's a variant called minimal traditional, which is actually really common in the Heights district. And most of those houses had sliding windows all throughout the house.
Right.
The characteristic features of that style would be, you know, the one-story design. It takes elements of ranch style, so it has the low slung, deep eaves, very horizontal. And you kind of get a sense of planes sliding past one another, and I think that's often why the sliding window was thought to be appropriate with that style. Double hung, while it does appear on minimal traditional houses, this particular type, you don't often see them in the Heights district. That being said, the idea of a garage enclosure, I think, is entirely appropriate because the roof already extended out that far. The massing was already there for it. So enclosing that space, I think, it would be architecturally appropriate and historically appropriate.
Right. And houses bordering that, many of them have have enclosed garages. And they were built, the houses were built that way originally.
Right.
Yeah.
And in fact, the style of the garage or the raised panel, that is characteristic of the minimal traditional style.
Thank you.
Now those windows are on the side of the house, they're going to be on the side of the garage. So.
Mm-hmm. Are they visible from the street?
They'll be visible from the north, if you're heading south.
If you're heading south, right.
Yeah.
me standing in the street.
Yeah. Looking down.
Well, we have a big flower garden there. I mean, you won't see it much in the summertime, but in the wintertime it will.
Other comments or concerns? Other than perhaps the style of the window? Not as something like,
okay, go ahead. The question we had was about the siding, that it would match the present style of siding that's on the house.
Yeah, we got the exact same side. Now, on the carport, the top is sided, already has siding, 5-inch double side. But we're going to go with new siding from the ground up to the top, so there won't be a variance in the color. I mean, they're both white, but just because it's old compared to new. So okay. We're going to have new from ground up.
So just on this end?
Yes.
On that end. So you're replacing, you're going all the way to the top of the gable?
We're replacing the siding on the top.
Okay. Yeah. And then that all will match the, okay, the yes. siding profile on the rest of the house.
Yes.
Okay. Okay, if there's no other commentary or concerns, someone like to make a motion? We've fully discussed the window style.
Well, I'm looking at number 9 under the Secretary of Interior's mm-hmm. guidelines. Mm-hmm. And one of the comments that's made there is that the architectural features should protect the historic integrity of the property. But it also says that new work should be differentiated from the old. So I don't really have a problem. It's not on the front of the house. It's not conflicting with windows that you would see visibly there. It is on the side. And I noticed that you did have a high bush there at one time that would have covered the windows.
Well, there's a lot that are not there now. You know, the plants have died.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
Perennials.
Yeah, mm-hmm. And a lot of them are annuals.
Oh, okay.
There is, I think from Alice's, there's a public right. I mean, the back of the house is visible. Are you putting any windows in the back of the garage?
Yeah.
You are same style of window?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, that's going to have one window.
One window? Okay. Yes. But it will still be the one over one, the double hung?
Yes.
Okay.
And that is visible from, even though it's landlocked, it's still visible from Alice's.
You might be able to see it from Alice's. The mm-hmm. only thing that I could see was of the rear, honestly, was coming from this direction,
okay.
The slight corner of the back, which I've approved. He's also replacing a rear screened in mm-hmm. porch in mm-hmm. kind.
Right.
You just said the posts were
termites.
Okay. Damage. And that probably sits low, right? That's a lower story than the
yes.
when you drive in,
yes.
right? Okay.
Nothing is changing,
okay.
So I approve
right.
that at staff
okay.
level, and that's
right.
on the staff approval.
Just putting in fresh wood,
yep.
mm-hmm. fresh beams.
Understood.
And we're using cedar.
Okay, that's nice. Okay.
It looks like I see one of the code officials' names on one of these documents. Was a permit obtained?
No.
Oh, okay.
The work was in progress, and it was asked to be stopped.
But the building inspectors have been out to look at it. Oh, on the plans, yes. He brought in plans for me to give to the building inspector.
For a motion?
I My only exception is the windows. Mm-hmm. So I would make a motion to approve the COA with the exception of the windows, and maybe we can vote on that separately. Is that possible?
To vote on the enclosure part first?
Right.
That as one motion?
Right. Okay. Everything but the windows.
Okay. All right. I think we can do that. All right. So your motion is in favor of enclosing the garage. Okay. All right. Is there a second on that?
Second.
Okay. Okay. Mr. Devine?
Yes.
Okay. Ms. Lasota?
Yes.
Mr. Booth?
Yes.
Okay. All right. Very good. So the garage enclosure is approved. Okay. So now the board is going to discuss the subject of the windows.
Okay.
And the appropriate style of the windows.
Okay.
Okay.
Because the picture of the garage door was sent in with a sunrise pattern, mm-hmm. do we have to address that separately too, or not? Because he says he is playing glass.
Right. I think, was that just the product brochure? That's not part of, the proposal is not to put in the sunrise, right?
Right, okay. Yes.
Okay. Just sometimes with just general brochures, and they offer different, window styles.
I can put it in the motion, or in the written resolution.
I think for clarity,
for plain glass as proposed, mm-hmm. or what was, as written or presented in an email, because mm-hmm. you said mm-hmm. that in your email. Yeah.
Right. Okay, so that's. Is there any further discussion about the windows? Someone willing to make a motion about the windows?
The struggle in my mind is, if these were sliders, can they be made sliders in that, in the size of the existing openings, the openings that have been framed, mm-hmm. in a way that makes them appropriate in terms of scale and proportion? Mm-hmm.
If we were to look at the rest of the house and see that, the front has three sets of sliders. There are single sets of sliders as well in the raised portion of the house. From a aesthetic point of view, do you think one set of sliders? They don't have to be that same height, do they? Do you think that's height that's currently in the house? Would it just, it's just style of the
because
window.
Even on the front elevation, there are two different
You're right,
heights.
There are different ones.
Mm-hmm. And there's a great example. In fact, the left side of the front elevation has three windows
mm-hmm.
in series, but there's space between, so mm-hmm. those are more punched openings.
Right.
The set that is looking into the living room mm-hmm. has three together that are mulled with a structural mullion. Mm-hmm. So that's another example of how to gang together three windows on the same building.
Mm-hmm.
Either of those could work. But my concern would be if they were to go to sliders, they would become a lot more vertical in proportion than the existing windows.
So the question is using sliders and trying to fit them in that current opening.
Right. I'd really hate to have this be reframed.
Yeah.
But I'm not quite sure how to. Maybe they could just be picture windows, and mm-hmm. but then that eliminates the ability to ventilate the garage.
Right. If they had to make that entire window opening right now, the cutout smaller, is infilling, is that troublesome?
I don't know. Do you know if there are two structural mullions in the middle, Are they in fact structural, or does the header go all the way across the three windows?
It goes all the way across.
So it's one large. So it's one large opening then.
Yeah.
Okay.
That could help.
Okay. Yeah, it's hard to tell if there's.
I mean, it may be possible in that case to do two sliders mm-hmm. and get closer to the proportions mm-hmm. yeah. of the existing windows.
Yeah.
So you'd have four glass panels.
Four glass panels, right.
We would also like to use it as a wood shop, and that was one of the reasons we did it, so we could open a window and put an exhaust fan in there mm-hmm. to take out some sawdust, mm-hmm. which I don't know how well that would work with a slider.
You're concerned about the opening being too large?
Yeah.
And how is your exhaust fan? What type of a fan is it?
It's just a box fan.
Oh, okay. So you're just looking to put it in a window
right,
opening
to ventilation.
Close it as tight as possible.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So with a slider, you'd need some kind of a blank off panel at the portion that's not filled up by the fan.
Right. Because that would, we won't have a fan that high.
Mm-hmm. And this is just a temporary condition while you're working in there?
Right.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you could temporarily use a material to block that, just to close that, the upper part of that, if you're putting your fan in the lower part of the window.
Okay.
Do other board members feel that these should be changed out to sliders?
The pattern you mentioned on the front is like 3 and 3. Mm-hmm. If we go to the side, now we're changing a pattern to 2. I'm kind of torn between keeping the 3-3-3 pattern.
Hmm.
It's
like there's some degree of consistency when you've got the 3 and the 3.
Mm-hmm.
Although, like Mr. Booth said, the upper part of the house has the individual sliders. I believe three, at least two or three. I can see from the picture.
Not to throw you off, but. Next to the door, there is a vertical mullion side light. I mean, it's horizontal mullion side light.
Mm-hmm. Are those windows, did you replace the main house windows at any point?
No.
You didn't, okay, so that's how it was, okay. Yeah. Just curious. I still feel though the main windows.
Oh yeah.
Kind of set the style.
Mm-hmm. Oh, definitely. Yeah.
It gives the building this style mm-hmm. a modern.
Yeah, it
edge.
Does. Yeah, instead of that traditional double.
It's kind of a hodgepodge. Mm-hmm. There are some historical references, but it's very, very much influenced by mm-hmm. the mid-century
mm-hmm.
modern.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just pointing out that, I just said that because just to point out that that's not all vertical.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah, no, I'm glad you did.
Mm-hmm. Sorry.
rear window in the garage is also a double hung, correct?
Yes. Mm-hmm. You said there's one window in the back of the garage. Yeah, it's the same style as the one that's... And it's installed, I assume?
No.
No, it's not installed yet?
No.
Okay.
Do we have any photos of that?
No, I can't.
It's not visible.
Yeah, it's not really visible unless you can peer through from the street below. Mm-hmm. But when I was driving around the block, I honestly couldn't tell what back
there's
was
a lot of
which.
Trees back there.
Yeah,
versus
in between the
properties. In between the houses, right.
So that double hung window then could be used as the exhaust window.
Mm-hmm.
That's
a good idea.
Since it's not visible.
Mm-hmm. Are there sliders in the rear of the house as well?
Yes.
Slider was, okay. So the whole house is really consistent with the sliders?
Yes.
Okay. Even though the back of the house is not really in question here, does that compel the board to feel as though a more appropriate window choice would be preferred?
Sorry, what was the question?
Okay. Because the whole house is using sliders, even though the rear is not visible and it's not under review tonight, but the fact is this style of house, the sliders are appropriate and likely original to the house. Given the fact that the entire house uses sliders, does that convince or compel the board to feel as though it's more even more necessary to have sliders in the garage on the north elevation?
At the beginning of the discussion, I was kind of conflicted myself, going back and forth, trying to make that decision. Mm-hmm. With everything that we've kind of deducted, it sounds like it'd be more appropriate to have at least two sliders at that elevation.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Want to make a motion?
Is there any conflict with that?
My only question is two the right number to get us close to the proportions of the other windows?
Mm-hmm.
We're looking at an elevation in perspective, mm-hmm. so it's hard to tell whether two is the right number, and that's going to give you the sash proportions that are close to what you have now.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Maybe there might be a staff level intermediate review just to verify that.
Right. So, so you could, we could get a proposal from the homeowner, from the contractor to ensure that it looks good. Amy can review that. She can consult with the board if there's some concern about the proportion of making sure that it is in keeping with the windows and the rest of the house.
Okay.
If that's the way the board votes, that's what we're talking about.
Okay.
Would you be willing to do a motion conditional on that?
I don't know. There's still an argument between style and configuration. You know, we'd be accomplishing the style by having verticals with two, but then the three throws off the configuration.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So I'm still kind of going back
conflicted,
and forth.
Whether it's style or configuration, right? Yeah.
Both
whether it's style or the cluster, the number of them, yeah.
Both are important. Mm-hmm. Is there one that's more important than the other?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Well, my opinion is just given the fact that the house, you've got three sets in the front, you have individual ones. You don't have any pictures in the rear, do you? Okay. I think based on experience from the board, perhaps that
it's
better to have the style. Yeah,
the style.
Yeah. But it's really up to the board what they want to do.
Are there other locations on the house where they don't occur in threes?
Well, sure. In the kitchen, there's one. in the back part of the living room, there's two individual windows. The bedrooms have. The master bedroom has one window, one in the front, one on the side.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Same with the back window. That has one on the side, two in the back. So it varies.
So it is a variety. Yeah. Okay. Does that pacify your concerns at all, or any more?
I don't know that I can make a strong stance either way, but we'll concede to the overall position of the board.
Is he going to have to change the opening, existing opening?
He would be working in the existing overall opening. So those three windows are part of the same structural opening.
Uh-huh. Okay.
The two verticals would come out. And then I guess it would be up to the applicant whether a single vertical that had some width to it was mm-hmm. incorporated, or, I mean, probably like your living room windows would be a good precedent, whatever width that is for the structural mullion. Maybe getting close to that. Mm-hmm. But it's hard to say until you see them in elevation and see the size of the window based on that right. vertical mm-hmm. dimension, what the space in between should be. You know what I mean? And that's the only thing that I'm hedging
yeah.
on. That's why I'm suggesting there would be a staff
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
level review of mm-hmm. it.
Be a good check to have.
So, I mean, I'll go ahead and make a motion. I don't know if it'll get a second, but for denial of the three double hung windows and for reconfiguration, removal of the two vertical mullions and incorporation of two sliding windows
okay.
in its place
okay.
to match existing.
Mm-hmm. All right, is there a second on the board?
I'll second.
Okay. All right, Mr. Devine?
Yes.
Okay. Ms. Lasota?
Yes.
And Mr. Booth?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, so we're asking you to look at it. Configuration of the windows, I'm sure you follow the discussion well, but what we're asking, I think at this point, is for you to talk to your contractor and propose back to Amy the configuration using the verticals
okay.
And heeding Mr. Booth's advice to maybe try to use those triples in the front to understand maybe the distance between the windows or the vertical mullion, the structural mullion, is what you called it?
Mm-hmm.
Yep, okay. And then to have that reviewed, if she does need some support from the board to ensure that it's appropriate, then okay. she will. And then hopefully that's what you need to move forward with changing out those windows. And the vote didn't have to include anything in the rear, so whatever you want to keep in the rear of the garage is
okay.
completely up to you. Of course, we would like for you to have the same windows, but that's completely up to you.
Yeah, of course.
Have to throw that in.
Yeah, okay.
And you can move forward with getting the building permit and with the garage other than the windows.
Yeah, but I guess you'll have to wait on the siding until you can figure out what exactly
yeah.
you can use that opening, or maybe you'd have to
reframe
it, maybe
okay.
make it smaller or something
mm-hmm.
like that. Hopefully
okay.
it's something you can work within the existing opening, and
yeah.
it's not
okay.
too much of a hardship
okay.
to find those windows
okay.
that will fit that.
All right.
And
so
it'll look appropriate.
I cannot go forward until I get those other windows approved? Is that right?
No, you can move forward like installing the garage door.
Oh,
they've
okay.
other work,
that.
Yeah.
Yes.
But when it comes
other
to the
work.
Windows, but obviously you can't side it until you really know you're going to use. You can't at least side the side of the garage until you know that existing opening is going
okay.
to work with different window configuration, different window style rather.
So you'll need a copy or a photo of the type of windows that we're going to put in.
The kind
the
of windows.
And a drawing, like, yes, a scale drawing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Like, it's just simple, like you submitted,
yeah.
but that shows, you
okay.
know, what the dimensions are.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah, so overall dimensions
right,
of the
right.
Okay.
House. And it won't require coming back to another meeting as soon as you submit that.
I just give those to
yeah,
Amy.
You
yes.
give that to Ms. Johnson, and
okay.
she can approve if she feels it's appropriate. If she needs some consult from the board, she
okay.
can do that as well.
Yeah. All right.
Okay?
Okay.
All right. Thank
so
you
I
for your time
So I can tell my
today.
Contractor he's good to go.
Yes.
Except for the windows.
I think, I can't remember. Oh.
I mean, he has
they
to
have
their,
your
right?
building permit upstairs.
Uh-huh.
So I just need to sign off. But well, I guess, I don't know what to say because it's not really. Yeah, I guess I could sign off on the building permit application, but we just have to deal with the window issue.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
We voted on it separately,
yeah.
so
right, yeah, right.
basically handle everything
right.
but the windows.
Mm-hmm,
mm-hmm.
Right.
Approval.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
Thank you, sir. Thanks for your time tonight.
You're welcome.
All right.
Thanks for having
me.
Thank
you.
My
notes aren't going to make any sense, but
that's okay. I can always figure them out.
There's not room for two motions.
Okay.
I got it.
Okay.
Anyway.
Are you good?
Yeah,
okay, good.
Yeah.
Okay. The next applicant, 144 North Fifth Street. Come forward, please.
Good evening, everybody.
Good evening. How are you?
So this is 144 North Fifth Street. This three-story attached painted brick commercial and residential building built in the Italianate style is located in the Callow Hill Historic District. The structure features a bracketed roof cornice with carved wood detailing, 1/1 wood windows on the upper floors with simple lintels and sills, and a marble foundation and trim around the storefront window and entry. The storefront window is divided vertically into three sections with leaded glass transoms. The structure received a site quality rating of 74, deeming it a contributing building in the district. And the Secretary of the Interior standards that apply are numbers 2, 5, and 6, of which I read earlier. And tonight we are reviewing the proposal for the replacement of the existing entrance door.
Okay.
Okay.
Go ahead, please.
So I know that everybody have copies of what I am presenting here. So in this picture we have the existing conditions of the door. And it is in really, really, really bad shape. That's what I want to replace it. Amy suggested me that if I wanted to get it repaired, but if you took a really good, really close look of every corner of the door, you will see that this, I think it's not working. It is a simple door, and I also understand that this is not the original door of the building, right? I wasn't able to see I looked for it, but I wasn't able to find a picture showing the original door, but I have spoken to a lot of people and this is not the original door of the building. So I'm planning to just replace it with something similar. This is what I am proposing, and I am gonna have a translucent panel as well. It will not be like this, mm-hmm. but this is the shape of the door that I would like to install. Mm-hmm. It is not going to be this color, it's going to be a darker brown. And it is a fiberglass door, it's not a wood door. I provided Amy with a quote that I got for a wood door, and it was really high.
So I did provide that to them as well.
So that's all I have.
Okay, questions on the board?
The executive committee had asked about the hardware that you're going to use on the door.
Yeah. I want to use something simple, not really fancy, but of course I will follow your recommendation. And I'm sorry that I didn't send you an email with that earlier, Amy, but it was a crazy day. So what I'm planning to use, I'm going to pass it around if you want to take a look, the one on the left.
This one or this one?
This one.
This one.
Mm-hmm. Cool. Ms. Johnson, we have approved alternate materials for front doors.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
And
for commercial and residential.
Okay.
And you said the door materials, fiberglass, did you say?
Yes.
Okay.
All right, so wood to fiberglass?
Yes.
Okay.
And
which one was it, this one?
Yes.
On the far right?
Okay.
It's just a lever.
Yeah.
And,
requirement?
I was going to ask Aaron, because it's a commercial building, but it's not ADA accessible because of the stairs.
Well, ADA is not just for wheelchair bound
occupants. That's
true.
That's right, yes.
Mm-hmm. It's for any physical impairment.
Mm-hmm. Sorry, yes.
So the lever style would be required?
It can't require tight grasping or twisting.
Okay. But it could be like a, could squeeze it.
I thought it was something like You could easily, like, if you didn't have the movement of
okay.
your fingers,
mm-hmm.
you can use your wrist
right.
or any part
your
of
arm
your
or something.
Push
okay,
it down.
Even your elbow
so
if you had
right,
to or something.
Grab
okay.
it, yeah.
I see.
That's how I understood it anyway.
So then having to
yeah,
engage
so
something
do.
With a thumb would be difficult.
Right.
Okay, I understand. Like the kind you have now, probably. Yeah.
Well, this is actually.
That, okay.
That's just
even
kind
the
low okay.
indexes in there was in such a bad condition.
Well, okay.
That
is that just
yeah, just something.
It just
yeah.
pulls
yeah.
pull.
Okay.
Yeah. Or put you push it in, right?
Yeah. Is this the one that was submitted?
Yeah.
He's submitting
he's
it now.
Yeah.
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 I mean, it is a more modern
mm-hmm, it is.
Style
yeah.
in terms of the trim and,
mm-hmm.
and the lever, but
mm-hmm.
It meets code requirements.
Right. Right.
I mean, I pictured something more to the left of that, but...
Like
that's still a lever,
big.
But maybe more traditional?
Yeah, the more traditional one. Because
this style of this building feels...
Like this?
Yeah. Or even to the left of that, but I guess that's not acceptable,
these would
right?
not be code
yeah.
compliant. A thumb latch.
But something that, yeah, has a more curve to it,
mm-hmm.
not...
Mm-hmm.
So modern looking.
What was your description? What was the style of the building?
It's Italianate.
Italianate.
Okay.
I'm
just trying to find
the color. Because those panels on the front, like the framing around the door and the marble, it
well,
kind of suggests like an Art Deco. Even the way the
yeah,
you know what
yeah,
I mean.
I was thinking
yeah.
the same thing. That's why I'm looking at
yeah.
the escutcheons on these two.
Uh huh.
And thinking about the way that that door was cased out.
Yes,
it's
exactly.
A little awkward because they're
yeah.
trying to
it's
shrink
just,
the
right,
door.
Right,
but because
like you
it
can
has
see
that
those steps.
Detail,
yeah.
that sort of mirrors.
That's what I'm thinking.
On.
Yeah, and it seems to kind of fit the stepping over the, you know, the detailing over the large picture window and the doorway.
Yeah, no, obviously the storefront's been changed.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
up above here.
Clearly,
is
like where the cornice is.
Yes.
Yeah, there actually there's a lot of really.
Yeah,
detail
nice details.
Yeah. A lot of detail. It's very nice.
I'm just going to write this down.
The only other question that I have is the fact that it's fiberglass, trying to make it look like wood. I think sometimes if it's not a real wood grain, depending on how it's rendered, you know, a lot of times they'll scan the image of wood and print it on whatever overlay is applied to the door. Sometimes it can be really convincing, and other times not as convincing. The alternative with non-wood materials is just to paint them. And if you brush paint something that's not wood, you can't tell that it's not wood, because typically, you can't see the wood grain through a painted finish, especially historical painted finishes, because they're so heavy. There's so much of the build.
Mm-hmm.
So that would be the other approach, is just go with a painted finish.
Well, let me just comment something. This is a picture that I took of the door that I want. And unfortunately, the picture doesn't give any justice to it. But if you get to see it close, it has texture as if it be wood.
Mm-hmm.
So, and that's what I like this.
Like real texture?
Isn't
you can feel
yeah.
the texture? Oh, okay.
Yes.
Like an open should grain?
Yeah.
Is it true to this picture, do you think? This mahogany?
No, that's why I
grain?
Took a picture of this
okay.
one and I printed it large, because right there you really cannot see it.
Yeah,
here
it's
you can.
A little grainy though.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But as Aaron was saying, that is just like a picture of the texture, whereas on here, there is really
you
texture.
Can, yeah, like if you kind of take your nails over, you
yes.
can feel the texture. Okay.
Oh, okay. All right.
So not just a simulated texture,
per se.
Mm-hmm. He's proposing mahogany grain.
What was the purpose of, I see the dimensional drawing,
yeah.
Is that to indicate the dimensions of the stiles and rails, or was there some
yeah.
kind of sticking
Just wanted to point out that this is 14 inches, and there's no other door that I can have that in 14 inches unless it is a custom-made door, which would bring the price so high. These doors have 10 inches on the bottom
10.
Portion.
Okay, so 14
10
to 10.
10 instead of 14. So yeah, and I bring this up because I wanted to show you the really ugly conditions that the door has.
And I've never seen, I told Mika, I've never seen a picture of that, like an old picture of that.
So you don't know what
buildings.
Was in there originally.
Yeah,
yeah.
To show what that door
is. Probably a porter.
That's what I think.
Oh, what?
The door is wide enough. A pair of
doors. Oh, a pair of
doors.
Yeah, you did say that last week.
You know,
yeah.
Amy mentioned that to me, but I don't think so. This is a picture of the inside of the vestibule.
How wide is that? Do you know?
This is 3 feet, and there's like around 14 inches here and 14 inches here. So I don't think that there was a...
That would do it. A lot of time the pairs are often
really
not
narrow,
more than
aren't
2 feet.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And like neighboring properties, are there any double doors, entrance doors original that you...
Or that you've seen?
No.
No? Okay.
A lot of them
sometimes
are
it's a,
like the full glass.
Just the full, okay.
Trying to think. Yeah.
What does WCR have?
Ah, that's a good question.
There are single doors as well. Right?
Is it a single? Yeah. I think it might be leaded glass. I don't remember.
The Art Deco building, the 134, that's a pair, but that's like a pair of commercial doors that are full glass. The Berkshire building, I think, are double doors too. But it's much wider.
Yeah, it's different.
There are some further down on North Fifth.
Yes, definitely.
Yeah,
those large townhomes
that are
doubles. Yeah.
We don't have a door policy, so there's nothing in the policy that would stipulate that this has to be wood for wood. The standards would recommend it, but based on precedents of previous applications. Mm-hmm. An alternate material could be approved.
Yes.
And being the door is not original, this is as close to an in-kind replacement as would be reasonable. And you're not proposing any leaded glass, it's just a single pane of glass. So the only other question would be the appropriateness
the hardware.
Of the hardware.
The lever style, does the board have a preference on a more contemporary or curved? Well, the one that probably like that one up there, the top middle, like a curved handle, is that one? Yeah, I mean in that style.
This one.
And is it the matte? Which fin? What color? Were you looking for like a brass or a?
Well, the one that I
the
showed
brush silver.
In the picture that I selected, that's the color and the shape that I would like.
Okay,
to
I see.
So.
Okay.
So you want to go with the satin then?
Yeah, they
are. Okay.
Referred to down there. But it sounds like the general consensus is the curved handle. Is that what I heard?
Not necessarily,
oh.
No.
I mean, it should be considered, but it's, I don't know that it's the preference.
The sconces that are around the door frame, are they a brass finish? They appear to be.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. And you plan to keep those?
Honestly, I haven't thought about it.
Okay. All right. Just one more thing to keep them. But my point is maybe you want to match the door hardware to those.
Even though I don't think they're original.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
I would like to put something better. Honestly, I don't like it.
Yeah.
Yeah, they don't look original. I can't really tell.
Yeah,
about.
I think the board approved them many years
many
ago.
Many years ago. Okay.
The previous owner was
okay.
Doing things to the building.
Got it.
Any preferences on hardware?
The lines on the first floor, the marble and all, are also vertical and horizontal. Mm-hmm, that mm-hmm. having, it doesn't really matter.
Yeah, yeah, it's very angular. Uh-huh, yeah, yeah, really. And geometric. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
But that might be more appropriate to mm-hmm. just have
Just have the simple, more modern hardware. You could make a case for that.
Yeah, I mean, I think this is where differentiation starts to come in. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And even the stepping casing around the door,
yeah.
it's not original. It's
no.
not a detail that you want to try to emulate mm-hmm. because it's not a character-defining
yeah.
feature of the building.
But it's still there. To, you know, it's
right.
still a condition you have to at least consider. Yeah.
The railings look beautiful, though. The wrought iron.
Oh, yeah. Yep, they do. Very nice.
Oops. Someone ready for a motion?
What's the hardware? No, we're not agreeing with the proposal. Mm-hmm. And then I move to approve a certificate of appropriateness for 144 North 5th based on the door measurements and product data supplied along with the latitude with century trim door hardware in satin nickel.
I'll second.
Okay,
one
second now. All right.
Okay.
Okay, Mr. Devine.
Yes.
Okay, Ms. Lasota.
Yes.
Mr. Booth.
Yes.
Okay. Okay.
Miguel, can you send me a color copy of that hardware page?
Okay.
Is that okay?
Yeah,
I'll
send you tomorrow.
Oh, that's perfect.
Okay.
Thank
okay.
you.
Thank you. All right. Thank
yeah.
you. Thank you. Have a nice holiday, too.
Likewise.
Okay. Thank you. All right. Okay. Representative from 126 South Fifth Street, come forward, please. Good evening.
How you doing?
Hello. The subject property is located in the Callow Hill Historic District. It is a three-story brick dwelling dating to the turn of the 20th century, which features a corner porch supported by squared columns, a picture window with an arched leaded glass transom, and an oriel window which spans the second and third stories. And the Secretary of the Interior standards that apply to the property are standards 2, 5, and 6, of which I read previously. And tonight we are reviewing the installation of a light fixture that's been installed, and the owner's request to maintain trash facilities behind the front gate, where it was previously approved to be in the rear. And the status of the restoration of the first floor front porch structure, of which was reviewed in July of 2017, and the replacement of the full glass panel on the front entrance door that has been missing for quite some time now.
Okay, welcome.
Right.
Comment?
I mean, basically for the 126, there is a light, a regular fluorescent light there that is like a 2 feet by 4. According to Amy, she say that that's not the light that should be there. So the only thing I can do is replace it by a regular traditional light, like maybe the size of that plot is about 12 inches with glass and inside with two light bulb.
Mm-hmm.
That would be, whatever recommendation you guys have for me to get. Regarding to the door, I just had to replace and they broke the glass,
okay.
So we replaced it with a plywood. Mm-hmm. I just had to go back and replace it for the glass.
Okay.
The door did have, the glass was in a starburst pattern.
Okay.
So the board should, if they're going to approve the replacement of glass, it should state that it's plain glass or back to the
original.
I don't know how feasible it
okay.
is to do a starburst pattern anymore. But
did you have a picture of that again? I know we
yeah.
reviewed that.
Okay.
And then do you want to talk about the trash can issue as well, the trash containers?
Amy suggested me to go put it all the way in the back, but 126 South, it doesn't have access through the back, like the other property. There is a little warehouse in the back that block the way from Fifth Street to Wood. There is a parking lot in Wood Street that is totally separate. It doesn't belong to the property. Even I own all the property around, but there is no access from 126 to Wood Street where the other property had the container.
Yeah, I didn't know because you have the parking lot in back of those garage buildings,
yeah.
Whether a truck could get in back there.
A truck
there.
Can get there, but there is no way for the tenant to go from 126 to the back. Because remember, there's a warehouse.
Okay, egress out of the house?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
So they'd have to come out the front door? How would they get out of the house and empty the trash?
Oh, they go, there is a little driveway between 126 and 130.
Okay.
So that's, you know, that there's a gate there, a metal gate that I put the container behind the gate.
Okay.
And that's in the pictures that I showed you.
Mm-hmm.
He's put it behind here.
Okay.
There.
And then the previous resolution, how did that address the trash containers? Just want to make sure this isn't a request for the same thing. In which case, can't really address that.
The previous resolution. Oh. It says the last portion of the resolution says the waste receptacles shall be stored in the rear of the property rather than the front.
Okay. And so now he's okay. So now this application is asking for the same thing that we previously denied?
Yes, sort of, but he's stating that he can't put them in the back.
Okay.
And he wants to put them in the front. So I don't know how to address
okay,
it. I guess.
Okay.
I mean, I guess just, it is. I mean, he's been violating for the past year
this resolution. Right.
And they were actually in front of the gate up until I sent the violation or the non-compliance letter.
Mm-hmm.
So then he put them behind the gate. But as you described to me, are you saying that the trucks or the whoever picks up the trash won't go into the back? Because if you could store it behind the building, there's no issue, and that's what this resolution had originally stated.
Well, what you need to understand, I mean, you are dealing with tenant. Even I have the container behind the gate. I have to be picking up garbage all the time in front of the gate.
Okay.
So if I take that all the way, there is a space all the way in the back, but still you want to be able to see it from the front of the building, because there is not like you can go behind the building. It's just a straight. So
it would be down what was that original driveway.
Yes.
Okay. It would still be visible.
Exactly.
Yeah. Because I think the concern may have been, you know, even with the trash cans, which is a better condition behind the gate rather than in front, there's still an invitation, I think, for people to try to slip in there and maybe throw some trash on top of the containers.
Mm.
So the board was, you know, asking I understand it may be inconvenient for your tenants. But not impossible, but inconvenient.
Yeah.
You know, could those be stored in the rear? Even less visible, I think, is better than fully visible right now. Yeah, I think that they're probably, I can't speak for the whole board, but I think the board would probably be more favorable toward that.
And Mr. Pepin suggested possibly an enclosure, which an enclosure would have to come before the review board as well. But so that might
Isn't this also a city ordinance? Doesn't it have to be in the back?
That's a good question.
Yeah.
Well,
you shouldn't have it in front of the building, but the reality, we don't have it in front of the building. We have next to the building because there is a driveway. So, because I have the building that's been, you know, having container in front of the building because they don't have access from the back.
Right.
And they say that I need to enclose the garbage container. But when we're talking about the front of the building versus the side of the building.
Mm-hmm.
So the ordinance says in front of the building. But we are in the side of the building.
Mm-hmm.
The dumpster ordinance states that it shouldn't be visible from a public right-of-way,
okay.
And then it has to be reviewed by the, if it has to be,
yeah.
If the owner's requesting it to be, then it has to be reviewed by the HARP.
And these are more than toters. This is a dumpster,
that's
right?
That's a dumpster, yeah.
So if you were to move it toward the back, it would still be visible down the driveway. It would just
yes.
be at the end of the drive. You can't tuck it around behind the back of the house. Are there other neighbors that have similar properties to yours that store their containers back there?
Most of the property, they have parking in the back.
Uh-huh.
And they had access from 5th Street back to Wood Street.
Mm-hmm.
126 doesn't have that.
Right. You so have those garages or
yeah.
you have those structures
yeah.
in the back that lock it in, right?
Yeah.
Okay. I know there's like a doorway between the properties, or at least when I was out there at one time, there was a
I did
door,
that for my own convenience, but when the state came for the daycare, they
made
it close. They said you have to enclose the playground.
Mm-hmm.
There should not be people walking through the where there are children.
That's
so that they
mean
enclose that.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. And it's not something that's visible from public right of way.
Right.
But that's why I was wondering if your tenants could walk through there. But I forgot. Now it's the
yeah.
play lot, basically,
yeah.
which is the next item on the
I'm
agenda.
I'm confused about something here, quick. The only new portion of this application is the light fixture. So if the other items are not new and they were previously decided upon, they would still be in violation. It's not an agreement. He has the opportunity to appeal that. I don't see how we can make any decisions on trash containers, about the porch that we have written down here, just the light and the door. And we don't have any product data on any to make any official decisions unless we have something in reference that we could suggest per his recommendation.
Mm-hmm.
Everything else is still within violation.
And the reason I put the porch on here is I wanted Mr. Pepin to explain why, what
that
is,
that
yeah,
that
where he's
sure.
at with it. That's the only, there's
yeah.
no change to what the board already approved, but.
But the work is not
the
done.
The work has not been done.
Right,
yes.
okay,
yes.
all right, with the resolution.
When
this
was that resolution again?
July 25th, 2017.
So it was beyond the six
oh,
months.
So this is the rear. This is the rear of the building.
So I, yes, so that's why I sent a non-compliance letter along with the light fixture being in violation.
So just for me, I like to keep things departmentalized. Is there any way that we could just break this up and do the COA for the light fixture if there is a
mm-hmm.
recommendation for that, and then break down the other items that were previously addressed?
Mm-hmm.
And then we can have open conversation about the other items for status updates.
Well, I agree with your first comments. The ordinance does not allow the HARP to hear appeals. So mm-hmm. if it's something that was part of a previous resolution, unless there's a proposal for something new,
we can't
we wouldn't
review
be
it.
Able to review that.
Mm-hmm.
But the light fixture is different. That's something new. That's,
right.
that's something that we can review.
Right. And the repair of the door, this is the plywood. It was broken after this resolution. That was not part of the original resolution, right?
Right.
It's
no,
about,
no,
technically, it's
yeah.
a violation right now
yes.
because it has to be
right.
has to be repaired.
Right.
All right.
And I guess I kind of looked at this as not as a truly new application, but he's requesting to have these in the front behind the gate where they have been out for the past year out front here in violation. So that's the difference I was looking at.
That's made to another entity,
yeah.
not us.
Yeah.
Because our resolution was clear and where
right.
it was.
And he didn't appeal in the 30 days.
Mm-hmm.
So
mm-hmm.
so what the board's saying is you have to move the trash receptacles to the back. And you just have to make your tenants.
All right.
I mean, other apartment buildings do. I mean, they don't have, you have a lot of space beside here, and a lot of buildings are even landlocked, and, you know, more row homes, and, you know, building on either side, and they don't have the space for it. Or they have to drag them through alleys. I mean, this is a generous amount of space compared to some buildings,
yeah.
you know, even.
Yeah, yeah. So
I see you want to be able to see it from the front.
Well, I mean, there's this. I know you can't put it up right up against this, but I think you did enclose this.
Yeah.
This is enclosed
yeah.
now.
Mm-hmm.
So, And I know there's a
fire escape.
Thank you. There. So, I mean, I didn't walk back there, so I don't know. I just know this is enclosed with a vinyl, so I don't know, can it be fit back here? And that would be out of view.
Yeah, but that's like if you go there, you have a couple of steps going up. That land is a little bit higher there than the sidewalk.
Right here.
Yeah.
Because this is, the way this is right here, it's all one level.
Like the grass area.
The grass area. I mean, this was taken in 2013, mm-hmm, but mm-hmm. This is all one level. Mm-hmm.
And indulge me again, can you just read the language in the resolution, last July's resolution, or from that meeting?
It says the waste receptacles shall be stored in the rear of the property rather than the front.
Okay.
It doesn't say out of view, but that is the dumpster ordinance.
Of course, yeah, so it has to be out of view. So even though this is an older photo, what we see is room, I don't know how you're going to do it, but Mr. Devine is correct in that the resolution that was voted on and passed back in July last year specified that your dumpsters and your trash receptacles have to be out of view and have to be stored in the back. So at this point, we really can't discuss that any further. Unfortunately, you know, the window to appeal is far gone, so you will have to comply with this. And if you don't, unfortunately, it can result in an escalation and further violations, okay? We don't want to put you in that position at this point. So if the board's okay, we'll move on from the trash issue and then just focus really in on what appears to be the light fixture. So yes. At the time last year, was there a light fixture present? Or was that was a light fixture part of any previous resolution?
No.
It wasn't?
The light
okay.
fixture's not, no.
So we still need product data on your light fixture selection. But I would be in favor of having that approved at staff level. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. But the current light, do you think the current light fixture?
No.
Oh, gosh. Yes.
It's
oh,
not
sorry.
Appropriate.
Yeah.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, sir, what was there before?
Nothing? Nothing.
So as long as you've owned the property, there was no other
was
light fixture?
Nice.
Other,
nope.
And you just recently installed the fluorescent?
Okay. Yeah, there, one of these pictures.
Do you have any pictures of what?
It shows some.
I see wires. I just
see
like
the
a
one
wire.
With the wires, yeah.
And you don't have any picture, any previous older photo that would suggest what
I'm
hiding there.
Because that was back to 2013.
Okay.
And I know I showed it to you.
I remember seeing something with wires hanging out. Yeah.
It's somewhere here.
Oh, it's probably talking to myself. I steal all your pictures.
But yeah, it's just a hole in the ceiling with wires. And that was in 2013, so there hasn't been anything. Mm-hmm.
So you had no light up there for a long time?
No.
You had no lighting on the porch? No lighting on the porch, sir? None?
Here's what the
right, yes,
saying.
I remember that. Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, most of these pictures are taken when the trees are out, so
it obscures the view.
Yeah.
Okay, all right. Well, the suggestion from the board was that you present a proposal for that, and you could approve potentially at staff level. Then.
Yeah.
Okay, all right. So, because there is some concern about the restoration work from the last resolution, do you want to quickly just review that? And I mean, I guess we have to discuss, is that in violation?
Yes, because you still remain in violation. The work hasn't been done. Number four of that resolution says the railing was taken care of. He did reinstall the railing. Number four states the HARB approves the reconstruction of the original concrete bullnose at the southern edge of the first floor front porch using cast-in-place concrete doweled into the existing slab to replicate the original profile of the bullnose. The radius of the bullnose is to begin close to the base of the columns, and the total thickness of the new concrete is to be approximately 4 inches thick. Any marred portions of the column bases are to be repaired to match the original shape and dimensions. So...
Really specific.
Yes, it's very specific. So you can literally, I mean, I told you you can take this to a mason, and a mason, yeah, there's many local masons.
I find somebody.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. And you just need to give them, I'll give you another copy of this, but, and they can talk to me. Okay. I can give them the original pictures. Well, I sent them to you.
I have it.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, and then the bottoms of the columns, because everything's been sheared off. When you look
at what the original condition
was,
right. Mm-hmm. Yep.
It just needs to be returned to that condition.
Right. That's what's stipulated in the resolution. Again, same with the trash containers, because you're past the point of being able to appeal that. We'd much rather you work with Amy if you have questions about how specific the resolution was and what that has to look like, rather than escalating this further. We want to work with you to make sure that the work is done in accordance with the resolution. And I know you've been before the board before, I think just as a caution, I mean, you're aware of where your property is and that it's in a historic district, and there are certain regulations that have to be reviewed by the board, certain changes that have to be reviewed by the board, and it's a better use of resources and better use of your time and of your money to be able to discuss those things prior before just going ahead and making changes. Okay, it's just a caution, sir.
And then my only other question is, the board okay with him just putting plain glass in the door?
Again, without product data. You know, speaking to someone that has that type of glass, I don't know how a decision could be made. You know, what type of glass? You know, what style of glass? Is there going to be Starburst?
One of the photos shows that it was a clear glass light, a single
with a Starburst. Well, it was etched in. Is that
what
it was?
Had like etched. Yes. Like Starburst.
Yeah, it did. It had a little etching to it. It's difficult
you
to
can't
see.
See it because
I thought
photographs.
You had a bigger picture, but I can't seem to find it in your file. Yeah, and the upper part, right, Amy? Was it like the upper third, maybe, of the glass? It's like an etch.
You're thinking that was original?
That's what my thinking was, yeah.
Which is, it's kind of unusual. Do you think it may not have been, Aaron?
I don't know. I can't see it in the photo.
Oh, yeah.
It could have also been a leaded glass, like many, many, many years ago, since there's so much leaded glass on the building. It could have had a full leaded glass
and this
door.
Could have been replaced in like the 70s or something.
That would,
mm-hmm.
Like I know, for instance, I'll use something that I know at where I used to live on Spring Street. The door had a Starburst in it, the other door in the 300 block, but the other doors on the other side had full leaded glass, so I know that was original to the building, and somewhere along the line, it got broken. But it's still,
else.
It was probably, I don't know when they did that, like 40s, 50s, maybe
I don't
30s,
know.
I don't know.
I would have thought it was a little later than that, but I don't know, yeah.
But our door did not have a leaded glass in it, because it had been replaced.
Okay, but it probably did originally.
Yes.
Yeah, like... in keeping with the neighboring houses.
But there is another door onto that porch that has
a single
clear glass light.
Right.
The one off to the right, kind of along the side there. Yeah.
I feel that is appropriate.
Just a solid glass.
Solid
if there's
glass.
An exact match of that, it would be appropriate.
Because this door here is a single glass. So to match it.
It has a mail slot in it, yep.
Okay. Also in the COA, item number 2 is to paint the exterior. Would that be reviewed at staff level?
Yes, I can approve that at staff level. I did not include that on the agenda.
Okay. But that was part of last year's resolution, though, painting?
No, that was done without any permission.
Got it.
Also.
Okay. Okay, so the light fixture, something's going to have to get proposed, but we can still, the board could still bring forth a motion with Amy approving that. And then in terms of the glass on the door,
the board is satisfied with matching the other door, the motion could include that as well. I think those are probably the two key items.
I mean, while you're already looking at lights and paint colors, might as well review glass too and have an improvement staff level.
That's fine.
So that would be a denial of this current COA for items to be improved in staff level, correct?
It would be a denial for the installed light fixture, if you so choose. And the painting, I might not have, it might have been my mistake of not putting it on the staff approvals. I did not. So I can add the painting to the staff approvals. And then just the glass in the door, if the board, whoever makes the motion wants me to approve a full glass door, I'm fine with that.
Okay.
And it's kind of tough to talk from the picture, so if you have an opportunity to review that,
you
know, what product day that you were to submit that's equal to what's already there, that'd be extremely helpful.
Yeah.
One-to-one match would be an easy decision.
Right.
All right, so I'll move to deny the certificate of appropriateness for 126 South 5th Street for the current installed light fixture at the first floor front porch. And for any replacement of glass to be reviewed at staff level.
Okay, both of those items at staff level. Okay.
So did you say you denied the installed light fixture?
Okay. Not the current light fixture.
Okay.
Any new light fixtures to be
approved. Okay.
Approved at staff level.
New.
Okay, is there a second to that?
I'll second.
Okay. Mr. Devine?
Yes.
And Mr. Booth?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, so on those two items, the glass and the door, and the light fixture in particular, because that's particularly, I mean, the doors, they're both very important, so we ask that you work with Ms. Johnson to ensure,
And the other items are still in violation.
Yeah. Okay, and Ms. Johnson is a resource, so before you embark on any work, just understand it's just going to be a better use of your time and resources, and the board's as well, and hers as well, to ensure that that everyone's on the same page in terms of the kind of work that you can approve and what the board has to review, okay? All right, thank you. She feverishly writes things down.
Okay.
All right.
So, Sean, or Aaron, Mr. Booth, seconds that. Okay.
Exactly, yep. Okay.
So right. He's for the next
one. For the next one, exactly. Yep. All right. Okay, 130 to 132 South 5th Street.
Right. The front facade of this commercial building was modified in the early 1900s with the application of pigmented structural glass, also known as Carrara glass or vitrolite. In 1996, the building was modified again under the city's facade improvement grant program, at which time the canopy with a stainless steel fascia and a new handicap accessible ramp with railings were installed. The structure received a site quality rating of 42 and is not a significant contributing site in the Callow Hill Historic District. And the Secretary of the Interior standards that apply to this project are 2, 5, and 6, of which I read previously. And tonight we are reviewing the installed fencing and solid wall that's been installed in order to enclose the play area in back of the building for the daycare tenant.
Right, okay. You're welcome to add some comment to that if you'd like, and just the work that you did and why you chose to do that.
Yeah, well, I mean, the state required that we provide safety for the kids. So when the lady came, she said we had to enclose the playground. And we had a handicap ramp that had made of railing.
Yep,
so she said we had to enclose that with plywood or some kind of material that would be safe for the kid to play around.
Okay, so they can't get in there.
So they can not get through.
Okay.
And that's why we did it.
Okay.
I mean, there is a fence that we did behind the playground. There is a vinyl fence. It's like about 5 feet high. And had a door, a little gate to get through the handicap ramp.
Yeah, we see that.
Yeah.
That's why I wasn't sure what the materials were exactly.
It's a vinyl
that were used.
And those
like the balustrade that's back there, those two large sections that are kind of elevated, is that wood or is, what is that exactly?
That's a vinyl.
That's vinyl as well? Okay.
In case the state required that we go higher a little bit with the fence.
Okay.
We were not sure.
Okay.
But that sounds like cutting down at any level that we want.
Okay. Could that have, was that required to be open or could you have used the same material that you used?
I can't. The state didn't say, when they came, that that's what they saw, that's what they say they want.
Okay.
For the playground.
Mm-hmm.
But in, I can do whatever you guys recommended.
Okay. Okay.
So this is just, this isn't wood, the solid is
that's
vinyl
minor.
As well. Okay.
Yeah.
So everything, I guess, even though it's different.
Like that.
Mm-hmm. Even completely solid.
Yeah.
It just looks like siding, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And the paint, I can do blue, I can do antique white, whatever color. Mm-hmm. I didn't finish because I was waiting for, the,
okay.
in case you guys decide to add.
Okay. Questions?
Whoops. The solid portion of the fence, I actually don't have any exception to it. It's the open portion at the back facing the parking lot. It looks like the sections of railing that were used aren't tall enough to meet the height requirement for whoever was mandating that this fence be installed. So there was a miscellaneous rail added underneath the railing section, and then there are some supports added in to keep it from sagging. It's just, it's not the right size railing section for the height requirement.
Right.
So we need something that's actually made for the height of that section. How high, what is the height requirement?
Yeah. So 5 feet.
5 feet, okay.
So 5 feet.
Does it, I'm sorry if you said this, but does it have to be open or can it be of the same material as the solid wall?
They didn't require any, they say, you know, the way that they that is now, that's what they require, but you are here, mm-hmm. the board, you decide whatever.
Is there a reason, if that is the case, is there a reason you didn't use that, you didn't carry that same material to the back?
The reason was because the front one is plywood. It's a treated plywood. So the one that enclosed the playground
mm-hmm.
around the railing, the metal railing.
Mm-hmm.
So I did the one in the back and just open it.
Oh.
It was just my choice.
Okay.
There was no requirement
okay.
or anything.
But you were required to close that
yeah.
off so the kids couldn't
yeah.
get into the handicap
yeah.
ramp. Through those railings, the
exactly.
blue railings.
What were you thinking?
No, I was just thinking maybe it was, I misunderstood, sorry.
No.
this solid though,
mm-hmm.
That is plywood.
Correct.
Oh, I thought you meant that that is vinyl. When I was talking about this, you meant this is vinyl.
Yeah, that's
okay.
Vinyl.
Okay,
yeah.
I'm sorry.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah,
so plywood.
I misunderstood.
So is that
yeah.
siding then that's facing the,
no, this is just plywood, pieces
painted
of
plywood.
Yeah.
But I see what looks like, what is that?
It looks like,
maybe
did
it's
you
just
take
a
like a 2x4? How did you create that top part of
the
top? Rail? Or the wall, sorry.
Yeah.
Like the top and then the section below the
yeah,
very top of it.
Yeah, that's just special wood.
Okay.
It's a hand rail.
Okay. So it's just an extra piece
yeah.
then or something.
Is it,
all
it's
right.
wider than the plywood,
yes.
so it's
yes.
making
a little wider, yeah.
the
okay.
line.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then
what?
You painted it. Then
yes.
okay, so it's painted
yeah.
plywood
yeah.
for an exterior enclosure. No,
that's
not gonna
basically a temporary installation.
Yeah. It's a treated plywood, and I painted,
mm-hmm.
and I'm waiting to finish the painting.
Mm-hmm.
It's a oil paint.
Okay.
So it will not destroy the plywood.
Yeah, it's typical.
It's exterior grade plywood.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
When I first saw the photos, I thought I was looking at some kind of V V-groove, tongue and groove board situation there, which would be appropriate. And that, something like that could be installed over top of the plywood. The plywood is essentially sheathing.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's not really meant for.
So that could be a substrate for some other kind of.
To be adhered to it, yeah.
Shiplap or whatever kind of clabber that goes on there.
But it's really not appropriate, even painted, there's not much.
It can be done, but exterior grade plywood is unpredictable and it comes in numerous grades. So unless it's the right grade of exterior plywood, it tends not to hold up. And even at that, we stopped specifying exterior grade plywood because we kept having issues with it. It was delaminating, dimensionally unstable.
Right, I would think the stability would be a bigger issue. Right, yeah.
What the lady with the daycare, what she had in mind, there is a plastic sheet, like a 2-4 millimeter thick, the one that people use in the kitchen and the bathroom, that she's planning to cover that.
That's called FRP, fiberglass reinforced panel. That would not be appropriate.
Yeah. That would warp too, right? I would say.
No,
it just wouldn't,
but
it's just
it wouldn't weather properly, yeah.
Is this his fence?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
So the board can consider something similar to the fence that's installed to the left.
Idea. Mm-hmm.
I see another issue here, though. It was a building permit applied for? Okay. So the code official needs to look at this because you have a fire escape coming down into that play area. And right now there's no gate. So their path to egress stops inside that play area.
Well, that was a recommendation by the state. We had that open. She said you had to enclose because the playground had to be separated from the people who enter to the daycare from the back. So it was open originally. So
when, there are children in that play area, and there's a fire on the inside, there's no way for them to get out of that play area. There's a gate to go up that handicap ramp.
Yeah.
Well, you can't access that.
Yeah. Go out, but they wouldn't know.
You would have to go towards the building, up on that platform, down and around that ramp.
Correct. Yes. That's the thing that the state came and the lady who came said you had to enclose that part. It was open originally.
And this was somebody from the state?
Yeah. It was originally open. The gate from the playground, she called me and said we had to enclose that.
Uh-huh.
Why was the gate put to the handicap ramp and not to that open?
The play area.
See, why was the gate put here to the ramp instead of here?
It should have been a zoning permit, too.
Because you have, that's a handicap entrance.
Right, I understand.
So what she say that...
be gated off, doesn't
it? Yeah. Originally, that wasn't there. It was open. Everything was, you get in, and she said you have to close that part because people who walk through there cannot have access to the ramp.
Understandable, but the ramp doesn't have to be gated off. It doesn't have to be an open and close gate there. Can be over here. So anybody in here, if there's a fire in the building, cannot escape.
I can move that gate to the...
Well, it's something that certainly should be considered, but then you're looking at different fencing opportunities that may be helpful to you. Right now, that is not good for anybody stuck in there. It's almost like a pen, and then the fire's coming out.
That's what I'm going to argue with you, because the state required that. That's the thing that we go out the state level.
It doesn't sound like they're requiring the gate to the ramp, though, from what you're saying. They
just
required a gate to the pen or the recreation area.
Yeah.
Aaron, do you specify gates to enter a handicap ramp?
Not typically. I understand why you have it there because a kid could potentially go back up on the porch
and run out.
Come around to the bottom of the ramp and go out.
Mm-hmm.
But I think maybe that's not planned for egress, and I think the building code official is going to want to look at that because the way it's configured right now would not be considered code compliant. It doesn't appear to be code compliant.
Right.
They do not have a building permit nor a zoning permit. A zoning permit would be required because this is considered fencing too, but it has to be code compliant and historically appropriate.
So I think you could do it by either reconfiguring the solid fence so that you could come out at the bottom of the ramp, but you'd have to change the way the gate is situated, or simply incorporate another gate in the play area side.
That leads out to the parking area?
That leads out to the parking area. Mm-hmm. So the means of egress has to be continuous from inside the building to a public right-of-way.
Mm-hmm.
But that's, again, that's the building code official's purview. We're looking at the historical
the
purview.
Materials.
Mm-hmm. I could see something similar to the solid fence condition carrying all the way across. I think the posts need to be cut down so that they're like the solid portion.
Mm-hmm. Just flush.
Yeah.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Or just completely enclosed
right.
by whatever cladding material is added to the to the face. And that the cladding material should be, you know, probably a V-groove, tongue and groove.
Mm-hmm.
It could be a shiplap, it could be, I don't know the clapboard is really the right thing here.
Aaron Weller pointed out that there is fencing here. I don't know if it would be appropriate to
We've
just
approved
continue.
That type of
yeah,
fence
I, I think we did approve that fence, did we not?
Yes, I think
yeah.
we did,
okay.
yes, because that was visible.
Right. So maybe it's a matter of...
So would it be possible to
mm-hmm.
use
mm-hmm.
the same style of fencing that you have between the
mm-hmm.
property, which is made for the outdoors, of course,
mm-hmm.
and
that's
structurally
yeah.
sound, instead of having this railing, use
mm-hmm.
the fencing as...
Right.
Would that have to continue, instead of that plywood, if that continued that same course path, using that fencing all the way around there?
So the same material everywhere.
The same material using that.
Yeah.
Of course.
Yeah.
Using, yeah.
That sounds like a best case scenario,
yeah.
and including a gate so people can exit out.
Right,
mm-hmm.
right.
The property at 136? Yeah, 136.
Okay.
They have a gate. There's a picture of it. They have a gate for that reason, because there's fire escapes between the buildings.
Okay.
So
and it leads right out to the parking
yeah.
area then.
And
okay.
we approve that. Yes, right here.
Oh,
so
right.
they
okay.
have a gate
uh-huh.
there
yep.
in the back.
Yep. Makes sense. You see it there? You got it in the picture. Okay.
Are you okay with approving that at staff level? We indicate the
well,
gate to the left as long as there's an indication of, for record keeping purposes, what the style is. And
yeah, if the board, I mean, the board can make a decision that this type of fencing was like, would be approved for the enclosure. The board has stipulated in the past with, or stipulated that the, what do I say, the building inspector, a building permit must be obtained
mm-hmm.
and this the project must be approved by the chief building official.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
And you're saying that you wouldn't need a gate here, or what did you say about the gate? I'm sorry.
If that were my area, I would feel better with a gate, knowing
yeah, yeah.
that it could be escaped.
But can the kids still get out behind, like by the back of the building
right.
and come around down?
Yeah, it's
yeah.
still a means of egress
right.
for that level of the building.
Uh-huh.
So I think the code official is going to say he wants the gate at the top of that short run of steps
mm-hmm.
on the back side of the play area.
Okay.
Oh, I see.
That way
okay.
you're not blocking egress down the ramp for
mm-hmm.
people who are coming out of the building.
Right, so they can be, the kids can be contained.
Right, they're
right.
still contained,
yeah.
they're in their corral,
yeah.
but the ramp isn't being obstructed.
Okay.
And where this wall is currently, sorry, the wall and the, the wall and this railing could just be this type of fencing
yes.
over here.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And then the gate would be back here, you're saying, where there's...
No, the gate
would be back here.
So we have
back
second
here.
Gate.
Okay, yes.
Yeah,
yes.
where those interior balustrades are now.
Okay.
Yeah. Railings.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So the COA is indicating enclosed playground with vinyl fences, which is correct. So... Would that be approved with specifics reviewed by preservation specialists? It doesn't say within there, enclosed with vinyl fences with specific heights and type of material. just says enclosed with vinyl fences.
Yeah, because he's calling this a vinyl fence.
The railing
and
part.
And the gate is vinyl fence. So the board can mandate that it's a certain type of fencing or whatever you feel is appropriate. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And given that there's an existing condition with another fence, that
right,
may be wise to
right,
specify that same kind of fencing,
and
same material and color.
The condition that mm-hmm, the chief building official mm-hmm, mm-hmm, approves the configuration. I'm not a loss for words.
Yeah,
no,
I think you're right. I got it. Yeah, yeah.
I'll give it a try.
Okay, all right.
So I'll make a motion to deny the COA for 130 to 132 South 5th Street as proposed, but to approve the installation of a vinyl fence similar to the one installed at the property boundary with 126 South 5th Street. Mm-hmm. That would be continuous around the play area, mm-hmm, and that would include a gate at the top landing adjacent to the building, mm-hmm, to contain the kids within the play area, and then another gate facing the parking lot to allow continuous egress from the play area for people using the fire escape. And that the gate at the bottom landing of the existing ramp would be eliminated. Mm-hmm. And the posts would be similar to the posts in the fence that's installed between 130, 132, mm-hmm, and 126.
Okay. Conditional okay, permit approval?
Yes, conditional yep, upon review and approval of the code official, and okay, also on review of the preservation officer.
Okay. Second? Yes? Okay. All right, Mr. Devine?
Yes.
All right, and Mr. Booth?
Yes.
Okay. Okay. You understand
yeah,
that? Okay.
I think it would look nice with
yeah, more
using
consistent
the existing mm-hmm, style of fencing.
Yeah.
Definitely. This railing
is what
remain,
it is,
but
yeah, but everything else would be a lot cleaner looking.
Painting
and consistent.
Is matter or leave it blue or it doesn't matter.
Isn't that part of a previous resolution?
Mm-hmm. I don't think we talk about
I
painting.
I don't think so.
I remember seeing a blue railing. Wasn't that
no,
problem?
It's been
was
blue
it?
For a while, but I mean, usually the board prefers black because it recedes more. It's not. I think the railing out front.
So
okay,
yeah,
that's what
I think
it was.
You're right.
I remember something.
But not
but the rear.
Here.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
If it were reviewed in front of the board, it's my initial position would be that it'd be the same color as the fence.
Yeah, that's true. Could you
right
paint
in
it? Could you paint it the same color
yeah, yeah,
as
yeah,
the
yeah,
fence?
But mm-hmm, if you do, please talk to Amy first before you do it, so that you have. You're approved.
Mm-hmm. You just
that
need to submit a paint color that would match yeah, that fence. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
But first we need to have the chief building official come and make a site visit, and I'm going to come with him,
okay,
too, so that we can all be on the same page.
All right. Sounds good.
Okay. All right.
Thank you.
Thank you very
thank
much.
You.
Thanks for
good
your
night
time this evening.
Thank you.
Okay. I mean, you still have to put all those.
Sorry.
Okay. So I don't think anyone's here for
503
answer.
No.
Okay.
No. So. I mean,
were you expecting anybody?
I was expecting.
You were.
But
okay. Oh, yeah,
I've talked
right,
to him and
right,
I've emailed him. Mm-hmm. But he did not come to the last time we had a review of his property. But the board did go ahead with.
We reviewed it anyway.
Reviewing,
okay,
yes.
All right.
Yeah.
Well, we should do the
so
same
if you
then
want to. I mean, it's pretty straightforward.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And I'd rather it's another violation.
Yeah. Yeah.
Take
yeah,
care
okay,
of it. If
the board okay,
that's okay,
reviewing without the applicant. Okay.
And then they run. They always run the risk
yep,
of anything
mm-hmm,
you decide. So they're warned.
Yep.
Everybody's warned.
I know.
Trust me. Okay, so this is 503 Windsor Street, and the subject property, built in the Queen Anne style, is located in the Center Park Historic District. The building is a 2 1/2-story brick row home, which features a gabled roof dormer, the original double wood entrance doors, and a decorative wood cornice. The front facade of the structure has recently been rehabilitated to include the removal of aluminum siding to expose the original brick facade. The structure received a site quality survey rating of 72 and is a contributing site in the district. And the standards that apply to this project are standards 9 and 10, of which I read earlier. And tonight we are reviewing the proposal for the installation of black metal fencing with entrance gates to that surrounds the parking lot on the western side of the property.
Okay.
And the fencing has been installed, as you saw in the pictures in your packets. And this was back in 2012 when the owner was having the work reviewed and approved by the board. He did submit a drawing. I think I included it in your packet. Showing what, oh, here it is. I'm not sure if it came after or during that time when we were reviewing it, but he did talk about at the time that he wanted to install a fence.
Okay.
Because what he's explained to me is he's had a lot of kids playing in the parking lot, mm-hmm. and of course, and people walking through, mm-hmm. and of course, he's liable for anything
sure.
that happens on that parking
yeah,
lot.
And it's,
so.
It's a busy corner.
Yes,
yeah.
It's a very busy corner. Mm-hmm. So he has improved it with flowers. And plantings. I did ask him about the sign that is the name of his management business, and he said he was only putting that up like for the construction, so he would like he will take
He'll
it down
that.
If
okay.
the board, you know, requests. But he also and he would said he would come to the board, but he was thinking of putting something nice about the district, like a sign on the fence, but that would come at a later
okay.
date.
Okay, that would be another application.
Yeah,
okay.
just
All
to
right.
give you the idea that he is
okay.
talking, thinking about putting something there.
Right.
But it's a style of fencing. I asked him for the style of fencing. He did not get back to me, so I don't know what the make
okay.
or style is.
Manufacturer.
But
mm-hmm.
it's very simple. It's not, I mean, no, the gates are more ornate.
Right.
than the actual fencing itself.
Yeah, but he never submitted an application for the fencing.
No,
it might have been in some renderings, but that's,
yes,
that's all it was.
Right.
Okay.
I was in the neighborhood looking at other properties and I saw that this had been installed. So rather than send a violation letter because it's not egregious
mm-hmm.
And he's been to the board before, I called him, well I put it before you guys
right.
first,
mm-hmm.
and then I called him and I said you need to get this formally approved.
Yeah.
So.
Yes.
But it's appropriate, I mean,
mm-hmm.
it's actually, you know, when you look at it like this, it's not, it's a low fence.
It is a very low fence, yeah.
Like it's, you know,
yeah, it really does kind of recede
it blends,
and blend.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
yeah. And he has done a beautiful job.
Mm-hmm. So had that not been installed, and this is what he was submitting, is the board agreeable to that style and color and material, knowing that we've approved fences like four?
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'll make a motion to approve
okay.
the COA for 503 Windsor Street
okay.
as proposed.
As proposed, okay.
Second.
Okay.
I'm sorry, what about the sign? Do you want to say something about the sign? I don't know how you feel. Yeah, I'm making it part of the application, the fence and the sign.
As part of the violation,
that on there?
Right.
It's, oh, I'm sorry, I didn't put that on there.
It's a temporary sign, it's not
right.
really fixed in any kind of way.
All right. I didn't know how you would view it, if it, like, as a temporary, I guess, yeah, it can be considered a temporary
mm-hmm.
sign.
But it's also been up for a long time.
Yes,
yeah.
I think so.
It's, I think it's expired its temporary status.
So, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So he would have to
I'm sorry.
That. No, that's okay.
Put
yeah.
that on.
But that does not
agenda.
Need to be part of the motion,
wanted,
right? Or do you want to?
I mean, we could
that?
Say that once work is completed, the sign be removed. If it's
I would just add to the motion,
okay.
amend the motion to include that the temporary sign be treated as required by the sign policy.
Mm-hmm. Willing to resecond that? Yep. Okay.
All right. Mr. Devine?
Yes.
Ms. Nassetta?
Yes.
Okay. And Mr. Booth?
Yes.
Okay. Very good. All right.
Good?
Yep, I'm good.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
Okay, so that is all the applications. Okay,
yes.
And I think you were recusing yourself from the staff vote. Is that right? Okay, all right. Is there a motion to approve the application staff?
Just one question,
okay.
Amy. Are you adding an F for 126?
Yes.
Okay.
I'm
with the
sorry.
Addition.
Yes,
right,
I'm
so
adding F for 126
okay.
for the painting
right.
of exterior surfaces.
Okay,
thank
you.
Cindy.
Thanks, Cindy. Okay. Is there a motion to approve?
Second.
Okay. Is there a second?
Second.
All right. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Okay. So approved. Okay. Other business.
Under the staff report, I honestly don't have a lot to report on because I've been involved in a few presentations and projects that I've been working on, and I have been working on the website a little bit, which
mm-hmm.
we'll get to.
Yep.
I just have the same court cases that I talked about last month and still in limbo, but that I'm working on. I did, we were talking about trying to reduce this list down.
Mm-hmm.
So what I did at the bottom, I put, just so I
good.
Keep track,
yeah, no, that's
properties
great.
And citation.
Mm-hmm.
So those are the ones that are currently going
okay.
back and forth between the road to court hearings
right.
and
okay.
citing them.
Okay.
I did put in a new citation for 833 Rose Street today and 450 South 7th Street. I had reported that had happened, but I checked. I don't know how, if I forgot or it didn't happen, I don't know,
mm-hmm.
but I submitted one for 450 South 7th Street and 833 Rose Street.
Okay.
So they will be cited.
Okay.
And
I'm still at 938 North 5th, you know, with the lime green calls.
Oh, yes,
yeah.
They haven't responded
yet. They haven't responded yet.
But
okay.
That letter just went out
just
right
recently.
After, yes.
Okay.
So
okay.
they
no
still
problem.
Are within their
so
14
days. So you wait for
the,
okay, you wait for
yeah.
the response.
Yeah, I've been working on other
okay.
violations.
Yeah, I know. They seem to
yes.
really be accumulating. Every time you drive through, there's more.
And I did take the other ones off of here. One that had been on here for a while was the restaurant on Penn Street. I was taking photographs, I can't think of the name of it, in the 1000 block of Penn Street, and they had a vinyl banner up
Boston
for a long,
House?
Not the Boston House, and the
You've
next block.
Row, right?
Oh,
a Caribbean restaurant?
The Caribbean restaurant,
okay,
yes. And they had a vinyl
Delight
banner up.
Something Delight, I think, right?
Yes. Or no, that's
no.
Cherry's.
House
okay.
Jerk,
that's
oh,
it.
That's
mm-hmm.
it, yeah.
That's
yeah.
It.
Yeah.
I was taking pictures, and the owner came
okay.
out and spoke to me. And
okay.
I said, I'm taking pictures because you've had this vinyl banner up. And he's like, I know. He goes, I'm thinking, rethinking my sign. I said, can you please take this banner
yeah.
down?
Yeah.
So as far as I know, he did. So that one I took
okay.
off the agenda.
Okay.
And there might have been a couple others that I reported on
okay.
last month. So I shortened it up a little bit. But that's what I thought I'd do is just keep the ones in citation.
That's good. Yeah.
Yeah.
yeah. And I know the last meeting I'm still thinking about, you know, there's a, without creating
yes,
any more work
no,
for you,
no.
but an easier way to kind of digest the information.
Yes. Yes. Oh, we talked about an Excel spreadsheet.
Yeah, something like
so
that. Yeah.
I'm
so
try,
I still
yeah.
process conceptualizing about
yeah,
that.
Yeah,
yeah,
yeah. yeah no, any, feel free to conceptualize
okay, right.
and give me
eventually have to actualize,
anything.
Though.
Yes.
Yeah.
I know. I know. So.
But yeah, because it is so much information and the list just continues
yes,
to grow as we
yes.
see more violations.
And
yeah.
I just have to, yeah, decide, like if it's an Excel, what's the information
yeah.
that's
mm-hmm,
going to
mm-hmm.
be, you know, the resolution that's non-compliance
right,
and things
exactly.
like that.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
yeah.
But I think we can probably find some categories or drop down for things that are more common
yes.
reasons for violations or violations.
Yes,
yeah.
right. Yeah.
Okay.
Nope, that's
okay.
a good idea.
Okay.
So, and then I'm sorry I failed to, I know you're going to do the board report, but I forgot to print out the resolutions for the June meeting, so I can do that after the meeting really quick.
Okay.
That's okay.
okay. Sure.
Or if you want me to wait, I think there's only three or four, and we can wait until next month. It's
okay.
up to you.
And you said emailing them is difficult to do.
Oh, I can email.
Okay. Okay.
If you want me to choose
yeah.
who gets what, like if it's in your neighborhood
yeah,
or something.
I think it's fine. It's only three
okay.
or four.
Oh,
I don't think
know.
We have a problem
is that
with that.
I'm happy
yeah.
to do
okay.
that.
Okay,
yep.
great. Super. Okay. Excellent. Okay, let's see. So board member report on the resolutions that were passed out at the last meeting. Anybody have?
I had 115 South Fifth Street, but that's a work in progress.
Okay.
So
okay.
I'll just hold on to it.
Okay. Yeah. Sure thing. Okay.
Yeah, they're not moving too quickly on
no.
that. I took more pictures.
You can't see because they have it covered with the plaque.
Yes.
Or whatever.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Mr. Vine, do you have any?
Yes. As of yesterday, the black wrought iron security door at the basement level and black wrought iron security bars at the basement level windows were still on at 433 Windsor.
Okay.
Right.
Oh, okay.
And I had one, but I'll be completely honest with you, I completely forgot about it, so I'll have to report on that at the next meeting. That was for, just so you know. I'm not sure where it is, but I'll find and report on it next month.
Okay.
Okay.
I have an older one that I did not get to look at, but it's, yeah, I'll report
okay.
on it next month.
Sure thing. All right. So, okay. The Education Outreach Committee reports. I know, Amy, you can probably speak to more specifics there.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Going through that.
So, we were... I worked with IT to actually get the maps up on the website mm-hmm. and linked. There's two places. There's in the main body of the
mm-hmm.
website,
mm-hmm.
And of course it still needs to be more developed. Like the copy needs to
yep.
be, you know,
built out for
yes.
the district.
I'm sorry,
yeah.
I cannot.
It's okay.
Sorry.
Like basic words, right?
Yeah.
yeah.
Yes. So feel free to help me.
From single syllable
yeah.
to like two
yes.
syllables,
yeah.
three.
Yeah. I don't know what it is. So they did it immediately. That's they're very good to me. They
act
they
react on, quickly.
Yes,
yeah.
yes.
Yeah.
And they'll tell me if they can. But
okay.
yes, they react very quickly and got the maps up. But then when I went to look at the maps, you can't read them. Like
yeah,
you can't see
the detail.
Streets. If you go in and look, you can't see the detail. And they took my PDF, and actually that was created by IT. And you just can't read it. You can almost can't even see the. You can see the
even at like a regular at 100% on the website. So
yeah.
anytime you try
and
to get
it. And there's no way.
Detail.
Yeah, there's no way of making it bigger. Or
so were those
like
PDFs? Was it? What program was the map built in? Or is that like,
I don't know.
It's not a scan or anything, is it, of a map?
No.
Okay,
she created
okay,
the
okay.
GIS person created
oh,
those maps.
I wonder if there's,
for
there's
me.
Something else. The original file. Whether there's something
I don't.
That can be done to...
Well, and I asked her... Okay, so then she did send me on Monday the other maps because there were... I'd only had Queen Anne, Callow Hill, and the Heights.
Mm-hmm.
So those got put up on the website.
Mm-hmm.
But then the other districts needed maps, single maps created. So she sent those to me, but I haven't had a chance to look at them
okay.
yet to make sure. But I'm sure they're fine. But then I caught her in the hallway, and I mentioned, she goes, yeah, I looked at the maps, and you can't read them. You can't read
street names
or anything.
Like that. Okay.
So she was going to talk with the other IT person
okay.
That works on the website and see if there's a way of getting it up so that you can read them. But I don't know what that
what
is,
that
if
be.
It's at
mm-hmm.
higher resolution
mm-hmm.
or I have no idea
okay.
if it's just the, like you said, the program that the map was created
yeah.
in. I
yeah.
know I don't know what the problem is.
If it helps your cause, those maps are extremely helpful
mm-hmm.
in trying to determine which properties are in historic.
Yes,
district.
Yeah.
So I'm
yes.
advising sellers on how to disclose information.
Yes.
And if I can't say.
Yeah.
Yes.
No, for someone that's on the board.
Yeah,
right.
That's right.
Well,
right.
I often ask you, and I might be
yeah.
a block off or something.
Yeah,
yeah.
yeah
like,
yeah.
oh, no, it starts in the 1000 block,
yeah.
and I'm in the 900
right.
block.
There's cases
or
where house lines make a difference.
Yes.
Right.
Yeah,
sure.
absolutely.
Sure,
yeah.
yeah.
There's liabilities
yeah.
that open up.
Of course, that. Yeah.
Well, the overall map is working. That and that one is highly legible. Like, I
okay.
can zoom in on this and see streets.
That's the city
okay.
map? Like, the
yeah,
main
the
one that was up there?
City
okay.
map. And that
in
has
different
the,
colors.
The HARP districts. But now if I go to individual districts, that's what you're saying.
Yes,
they were trying
the individual,
to work on.
Yes. And I had her remove what was up there was done by a previous consultant, and they took that map, and it shows the landmark buildings, the
mm-hmm.
ones that are listed on the National Register. That was up on our main landing page
okay.
for the district. So I had them remove that and
okay.
then put the map of the main historic districts
But I kept it as a link down below in the body. So I have to change the name of it. The name, I don't like how they named it, but so those are all things I just still need to work on.
Yeah, I can see the individual parcels. I'm looking at Capitol Hill.
And you, maybe they changed it.
They might have changed it this afternoon.
Yeah. Does it look better, Amy?
Yeah, he can, because I couldn't zoom in on it before.
Yeah, it looks like it's working.
Did you click on it and then?
Yeah, I clicked on Callow Hill District and this came up.
Okay. Yeah, see, and no, that is clear. I bet you they went and changed
it.
Okay. It looks like they have the boundary layer turned off, but otherwise it looks, it's legible.
And when you, when you zoomed, see, but you're zooming, like you're using touchscreen on the computer, you can't. There was no
and this is highly legible. I mean, this is...
Yeah, that's good.
I maybe think the puzzles are actually a better color here because they're a little bit darker.
Yeah, on the main map, that like some of those colors are really similar.
But that's very legible.
Oh, yeah. But you can increase the... You can zoom in on, things. You
if
can change
you click,
the...
Yeah, if you click on... Mm-hmm. But even when I... clicked on it before. Maybe she did go in and change things.
Well, it looks better. You'll have to ask her tomorrow.
Yeah, I'll have to try it myself. But yeah, no, that's definitely legible. So maybe they did work on it. And
yeah, the fact that they're all on here is great.
Yeah. So no, you're right. It's because I get people asking me all the time and other realtors, you know, what are the boundaries? Which I, of course, don't mind people asking me. I'd rather them, them ask me. But. Yeah.
But better just to refer to that instead of like, yeah, I think it is, or it's close.
Well, that's when you get text messages on the weekend.
Yes. Somebody texts me while I'm not working sometimes. Which I honestly
gotta know,
don't
though,
mind.
Right? I just seize the moment, right? I mean, whoever is asking that question. So.
I don't know. They must be completely
No, I don't mind
at
all.
You have to work, right?
I answered you right away, didn't I?
You did. I was just screening yourself.
Next time, make him wait a few days, right? Yeah.
Sometimes that's how deals roll.
Yeah, I'm sure. Call her. Just harass her that way.
If it was a virgin, I would call.
Yes. So, you know, I'll check it out for myself, but that looks good.
Mm-hmm. Okay, good. So we did the map and we're making other enhancements and continue to...
Yes.
Yeah, because there were a lot of little things that were... nothing major, but a lot of little links because there's so many links to the same thing. And so, like even Chapter 295, one of the links linked to something different than that. So we had to make sure that got done correctly. So we've been combing through and just... trying to get that done. So.
Yeah, and the links are in the body of that, but then they're over on the side too.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
That should all be good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay, good. Excellent. Okay, anything on the policy committee report? No, not at this point. I guess maybe for 2019, we could look at some goals for that perhaps.
Is it in order?
Well, it's a strong suggestion. In order. Would you like move faster if it were in order, a directive? It's okay. You guys worked really hard on the financial hardship policy, so I think that you have a well-deserved break from that, from things. Yeah.
That was a long time. No, a door policy would be very helpful because I get asked a lot. What am I required to do?
And to have
you know some sort of guidelines that would be helpful.
Yeah, knowing that there's a window policy, we've.
Right.
That's really helped to guide the board.
Yeah, yeah,
certainly. Okay.
I think we talked about that before.
We did.
That might be next in
line. Well, maybe that's something we can consider for next year. Okay. So if there's nothing else, then the chair will entertain a motion to adjourn. Okay, second. All right. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? All right. Thank you, everybody. Have a happy Thanksgiving.
You too.